dice.
By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his pal Mugman, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his pal Mugman, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his pal Mugman, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his pal Mugman, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his pal Mugman, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his pal Mugman, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his his pal Mugman. They like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission from
El gâteau. Non. Est-ce que vous m'entendez? Putain, ça augmente ça aussi. Oh, ah, c'est ça. Non, c'est pas bon. Ah, ça, en fait, on a pas besoin. Le Yeti, normalement, je vais m'entendre.
pleasure. One by Back and Boom.
Hurry, Uncle Scrooge! They're headed for your office!
Hold on, lad. I'll have you free in a jiffy.
Not so fast, McDuck. We're running things around here now.
Cuss me, kilt. One false move and I'm a roast duck.
Please be a Scrooge. It's not worth it.
Nonsense, my boy.
You'll never beat us, Scrooge. Hey, when I get the gold, I'm gonna buy Ma a new hat.
That lot of good that'll do us if they make it to me vault. Step away from me fortune, you crook.
Not this time, McDuck. Oh, you ain't getting the drop on this big old boy.
Your sail is securely suspended, son. There you are, sir.
Oh, my aching head.
Everything is ready, sir.
Who keeps a safe hanging from the ceiling?
There you are, sir.
Oh, talk about your unsafe safe.
Your safe is securely suspended, sir.
Curse you, McDuck! This ain't the last you'll see of me!
Yeah, good riddance to bad beagles, I say. Now, why in the world was he interested in this old painting? Surely there are more valuable... Well, pluck me pin feathers. It looks like some kind of secret code. Boys, boys!
What did you find, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, what is it?
I'm not sure. But I know how to find it out. I'll feed it into my supercomputer and use Gyro's new crypto analysis program. Then we'll know what the Beagle Boys were after. Stand back, lads. Brigadoon!
What is it, Uncle Scrooge?
It's a treasure map, lads. And no ordinary treasure by the look of things.
Only Uncle Scrooge would call any kind of treasure ordinary. Look! One of the treasures is in the middle of the Amazon! And there's another one in Transylvania! And one buried 10 miles underground! Hey, wait a minute! Something's screwy! This last treasure can't be right! Yeah, there's no mountain on Earth that's that high! Well, according to the Junior Woodchuck's guidebook, to get there we'd have to take about 537 million steps straight up till we reach the moon. You mean the moon?
It looks that way, lads. Well, what are we waiting for? That treasure's not going to discover itself.
Hmm.
launch pad on the horn. I'm headed to the Amazon jungle to find the scepter of the Incan king. Thanks for the lift, Launchpad.
No problemo. Lift is one of my favorite principles of aerodynamics. Oh, say, you got your radio, Mr. McD?
Aye, of course I do.
Great! Then I'll be your eyes in the sky.
Oh, I'd be happy if you just keep your eyes on the sky for once. What an airhead.
Hey, I heard that.
Now then, ancient Incan legends claim the king's scepter was locked away in a giant temple of the clouds, and it should be dead ahead.
Gee, Mr. McD, I see a lot of clouds, but no temple.
You wouldn't, Launchpad. The legend says the temple was hidden away from all but King Manco Capquac himself. But there's bound to be a way to reveal it buried somewhere in this overgrown salad bowl, and I'm not leaving till I find it.
Là, ça marche. Il faut que j'aille. Et c'est quoi ces points? Ah, c'était des pièces? Non, c'est des. Oh, donc, je pense que c'est des. Ça va être les pièces fortes après. Ok.
Launchpad, I found an ancient coin depicting a nightingale.
Edo, you haven't stumbled across a pizza joint down there, have you, Mr. McD? You're getting kind of hungry up here.
I'm not even going to dignify that question with a response. Another coin! And this one has an inscription of an eagle.
Eh ouais! Donc il faut que j'aille en dessous.
Aha! A coin bearing the image of the Queen's horse. Ha! It'll help us find the treasure for sure.
How can you tell, boss?
Never doubt the well-honed instincts of an experienced treasure hunter.
If you say so, Mr. McD.
Ugh, my arms are getting tired. Thank you. A coin showing the sun. Gads, I nearly tripped over it. This place is a mess. Where's Mrs. Beakley when you need her? How dare you? Would you look at the size of this diamond? Blast! Look at this, an ancient coin with the image of a scythe. It must represent a good harvest.
This is Launchpad, calling Mr. McD.
What is it, Launchpad?
I'm running a little low on fuel up here.
Well, where are the extra fuel canisters?
That's why I'm calling you, boss. I checked the glove compartment, but all I found was gloves.
Oh. at that luster.
Mrs. Beakley.
Here's a treasure nearby. I can smell it. There it is, the King's Scepter. Well, oh, this was easier to find than a penny in a parking lot. Catch me, kilts! What was that? We'll be right back.
Mr. McTee. This place has fallen to pieces.
No, I'm not leaving without that scepter. Get us out of here, Launchpad. I cannot believe we came all this way for nothing. What's the meaning of this?
Outsider, our prophecies have long foretold that our ancient city would one day be returned to us. For hundreds of years we have waited, and at last that day has come.
You mean you're not mad at me?
Mad? Quite the contrary, feathered one. Is there anything we can do to repay you?
Well, now that you mention it, I did come here looking for an ancient scepter. I didn't suppose...
Does it look like this? It fell from the temple.
Oh, they're climbing for nothing, eh, Mr. McDee?
Bless me, bagpipes, the scepter of the Incan King!
It is yours. Take it and go in peace. After all, it was just the old king's back scratcher.
Quelle heure est-il? 9h33. Eh bien, écoutez, j'espère que ça va bien pour vous.
The scepter of the Incan King. I tell you, boys, there's something special about this treasure.
Really, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, it just looks like an old back scratcher to us.
You boys need to learn some respect for the finer things in life. Now, if you're done having fun at your old uncle's expense, help me decide where we should go next. Pack your bags, boys. We're off to Transylvania, and we're no coming back without the coin of the Lost Realm. This is it, kids. Draculesti Manor, home of the legendary Drake von Vladstone, heir to the coin of the Lost Realm.
Boy, it's kind of creepy out here, isn't it? Uncle Scrooge, we're not going to break into this guy's house, are we?
Yeah, of course not, Louis. This castle has been abandoned for centuries.
Hey, look at this. The Junior Woodchuck Guidebook says Drake von Vladstone was best known by his nickname, Count Dracula Duck.
Is there really a monster in there, Uncle Scrooge?
Aw, don't be silly, Webby. Yeah, there's no such thing as Dracula. Right. He is right, isn't he, Uncle Scrooge?
Of course he is, Louis. Vampires, banshees, and mischievous spirits are just a lot of superstitious hocus-pocus. But you better stick close to me, just in case. Now you boys stay put and keep an eye on wee Webbergale. I'll be back with the treasure in no time.
Aw, nuts. We want to come with you, Uncle Scrooge.
Don't worry. I'll be back with the coin before you can say E pluribus unum.
E purple bus huum? Yeah, I'm not sure that's as fast as you think it is. Besides, why should we have to stay here just because Webby's a big chicken? Yeah, we're not afraid of whatever's hiding out there, are we? You boys are so mean. I'll show you who's not afraid of the dark. Wait, Webby! Oh, no!
Huey, Dewey, Louie!
Will they be all right, Uncle Scrooge?
Of course. Everything will be fine, my darling. Wait here and I'll be back with the lads lickety-split.
I'm out of here.
Hey, that wasn't a ghost at all. It was a beagle boy in disguise.
Trying to beat me to my treasure, no doubt. But it'll take more than just an old bedsheet and flower dust to frighten off Scrooge McDuck.
Look, Uncle Scrooge, that beagle boy dropped something. It's an old piece of paper.
Twist me, Tartan. It's an ancient rune.
You mean like a magic spell?
Aye, lad. At least part of one.
Gee, I wonder who tore it into pieces.
We'll worry about that later. Right now, I want you to head to the front door and wait for me. I'll be back once I've found the treasure. Off you go, lad.
Treasure!
Would you look at the size of this diamond?
Okay.
On that one. The money! Is there no end to this madness? Ooh! Nearly lost my hat on that one. Is there no end to this madness?
Any lunch?
No.
Okay, okay. You don't gotta be all touchy about it. See ya.
That guy gives me the heebie-jeebies. He was starting to look at me like I was lunch.
Well, next time he'll think twice before scrapping with Scrooge McDuck.
Speaking of scraps, he dropped this Uncle Scrooge.
Ah, it looks like another piece of that torn-up sorcery.
Say what?
A magic spell, and it's nearly complete. Just one piece left to find. If only I knew where to start looking.
Well, that bungle boy did say this house has an illusion wall. Do you think he meant...
Of course, a secret passage. Oh, no wonder I've been having so much trouble finding anything around here. Good lad. Now, off you go. I need you to wait at the entrance with the others.
Break. This is actually starting to be fun. Nearly lost my hat on that one. This is actually starting to be fun. Mrs. Bigley, is that you?
It most certainly is. Why, just look at all these cobwebs. This place could use a woman's touch.
Oh, thank you kindly, dear.
Go on, Mr. McDuck. No need to worry about me.
I've still got it. What a beautiful... Diamond the size of Mrs. Beagle. 1 billion one. 1 billion two. Watch this. Part of the spell matches the inscriptions on this mirror. Ugh, if only I had all the pieces to this puzzle. Madness.
lost my hat on that one. Nearly lost my hat on that one. Thank you, Abigail. That's so tough without your army helmet, eh?
Wait till the gang in Sing Sing finds out you were knocked flat by an old guy in his cane!
thank you, lad.
Yeah? Well, you better be careful where you go poking around, McDuck. or you's gonna have much bigger problems than me. So long.
Now, what do you suppose he meant by that? Ah, it doesn't matter. Quick, lad, see if there's a scrap of paper lying about.
You mean like this one, Uncle Scrooge?
Exactly. This is the last piece of the riddle.
But what to do?
That's what I'm about to find out. Quick, lad, go meet Webby and the others at the entrance. And all of you, stay put.
Treasure!
Bah non, mais je peux pas. Oh là.
There's a treasure nearby. I can smell it.
Ok, juste au-dessus. Mais j'ai une entrée au-dessus.
Onward and upward. Luck of the ducks! I solved the riddle!
What riddle, Uncle Scrooge?
Boys, I thought I told you to stay with Webby.
They did stay with me, Uncle Scrooge. I'm right here. Oh, what a pretty mirror.
Aye, lass. And if I'm right, using this spell will reveal the foul perpetrator behind all these shenanigans. Magic at the spell. Ach, I should have known you'd be behind this.
Oh, Scroogey, my old friend. You wouldn't believe how much fun it is watching you run around making a fool of yourself.
What?
Oh, you really don't think you need ancient sorcery to find Coin of Lost Realm, do you? No, I had Beetle Boy's hide paper scraps to throw you off trail.
Why, you sneaky, conniving...
Please, save compliments for garden party.
What garden party?
The one I will throw in celebration when I get home with lost coin. So long, fools!
Gee, she isn't very nice. You said it, Webby.
All right, you kids stay here. I'm going to track down that witch and give her a piece of my mind.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ow, ow, ow!
How dare you!
Scrooge, why must you always meddle? That coin is mine!
Bye.
blast these inferior mirror and beam spells. It's the last time I shop for spell ingredients at discount store. You haven't seen last of magic of the spell. You may have coin of lost realm, but your number one dime will soon be mine.
Thank you.
I'm like a money magnet. Why are you here, Mrs. Beakley?
The center of the earth is quite toasty, Mr. McDuck. I wanted to make sure you dressed in layers.
You're worth your weight in gold, Mrs. Beakley. If you'll pardon the expression.
Huh, of course. But I'll find my own way out, thank you very much.
Always an adventurer. By being foolish. Thank you.
pire, non, je suis bête. Autant finir le boss et après changer du jeu, je vous montrerai ce que c'est Castle of Elysium. Donc peut-être cet après-midi, ça pourrait être sympa. Peut-être l'après-midi, j'en sais rien, ou peut-être demain. Hein. Je vais au moins finir ce jeu.
Hold up under your assault no longer, stranger. What is it you wish from us?
Well, for starters, stop these infernal games. You're causing earthquakes, scaring off my workers, and ruining my equipment. It's now impossible to mine for diamonds.
Diamonds?
Aye, diamonds. Like this one. Though the particular one I'm after is a fair bit bigger.
Oh, you refer to garbage rocks. We have no use for garbage rocks. They're hard and sharp, and you can't roll on them at all.
You don't say. tell you what, I'll do you a favor and haul away your garbage rocks, free of charge. Just keep the earthquakes to a minimum, all right?
Agreed. I am proud to announce that the Terrafermians hereby welcome your garbage rock mining operation. Here, you can start by getting rid of this one.
Bless me, bagpipes. The giant diamond of the inner earth. That's right, Louie. It's as I told you, boys. There's a rational explanation for everything.
Yeah, a whole kingdom of underground creatures who cause earthquakes as part of a game is a completely rational explanation.
Never mind, boys. The point is, we made it back with a giant diamond of the inner earth and gained an entire diamond mine in the process. Now, where to next, lads?
Well, Cuphead and his Pelmug Man, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his Pelmug Man, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his Pelmug Man, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his Pelmug Man, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his Pelmug Man, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his Pelmug Man, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price. And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread. And if they proceed but don't succeed,
well,
the devil will take their heads. Well, Cuphead and his Pelmug Man, they like to roll.
Il y a eu un méga bug. La console s'était figée. J'étais content. J'ai failli mettre oui, hein, donc n'importe quoi.
Gee, Uncle Scrooge, you mean there weren't any ghosts down there after all?
That's right, Louie. It's as I told you, boys. There's a rational explanation for everything.
Yeah, a whole kingdom of underground creatures who cause earthquakes as part of a game is a completely rational explanation.
Never mind, boys. The point is, we made it back with the giant diamond of the inner earth and gained an entire diamond mine in the process. Now, where to next, lads? Pack my parka, Duckworth. We're headed for the Himalayas to hunt for the lost crown of Genghis Khan.
Shall I forward your call, sir?
Gee, can I come, Uncle Scrooge? I want to see the pretty Himalayan marmots.
Och, not this time, Wibby, darling. I need you here looking after the boys. Otherwise, who knows what kind of trouble they might get into.
Oh, that's very smart.
Uncle Scrooge!
Indulge me, lads. The last thing this expedition needs is a wee lass about. Ugh, I'm going to have enough trouble looking after the launch pad. Launch pad. I told you to land in the center of the mountain range, not in the center of a mountain.
Gee, Mr. McTee, I thought that crash was rock solid.
The only rocks around here are the ones inside your head. Ugh, we're nowhere near Shadow Pass and the Lost Crown. Now fix this wreck so we can get airborne and step on it, lad. I'm paying you by the hour, and I'll may have you billing me for overtime.
No problem, boss. As long as I have this fuel regulator, we're as good as... Whoopsie-daisy. Oops. My mom always said I was a Butterfingers.
Oh, no. Please tell me you've got another one of those.
Sure I do. But it's back in Duckburg.
Launch pad!
Don't worry, Mr. McDee. I'll climb down and get it.
You'll do no such thing. I'll get it. You stay here and try not to cause any more damage.
Okay, you're the boss.
Oh.
but... Here now, don't touch that. I need it to fix my plane. Stop! Oh, it's too late. Those bunny bandits have torn it apart. I've got to find those pieces fast. Bubba Duck! Looks like that poor little pea brain got caught in a deep freeze.
Whoa, what happened? Scrooge! Ooga Ooga! Scrooge saved Bubba!
There, there, little fella. Uncle Scrooge is here to help.
Scrooge saved Bubba! Scrooge saved Bubba! Scrooge saved Bubba! Bubba helped Scrooge! Bubba helped Scrooge forever!
You know, I could use a bit of help smashing away this giant icebox. What do you say, Bubba?
Ooga, ooga!
In that case, follow me, lad! The end of the line, Bubba. It's time for you to head to the surface.
Bubba home with Scrooge?
Aye. Launch pad is waiting to take you home to Duckburg. On your way now. That luster.
onward and upward. I go. Blast it. My feet are turning to ice. No point in hanging around here. It's the second piece of the fuel regulator. One more piece to find and we can get out of this overgrown icebox. Out of my way!
Thank you.
luck of the ducks! The last one! Now to get this fuel regulator back to launch pad.
Jusqu'au bout là-bas pour remonter comme j'ai fait tout à l'heure et repartir parce que là c'est chaud quoi. Je vais couper direct. On se donne rendez-vous tout à l'heure, je vais manger et je vous dis bon appétit à tous. Oh quoique non. Petite pause et je reviens. Je vais manger.
Well, Cuphead and his Pelmug Man.